So here's one thing I don't get is the negative aspects of narcissism. And when I say the negative aspect of it, basically the positive aspect is somebody thinking that they're perfect, somebody thinking that the world would just implode or something without them being there. And that, everybody else's lives are enriched by their mere presence. I've actually been taught to be a narcissist in the negative sense. And that is that I am responsible for every single fucking bad thing that has ever happened to anybody, and that has happened, and that ever will happen. I just create evil and suffering and pain wherever I go. And I've had people, on the quirky forum say that. I've had teachers say that. I have had family members say that. I mean, the thing of it is, it's like I cannot picture a normal, healthy person saying to another person, "You're evil." I can't. Honestly, I can't. And yet, I look at all the different things people have said to me throughout my life, and it's this common theme that I'm evil, that I'm unwanted, that I'm inconvenient, that I shouldn't be here, that I need to self-erase. Another aspect of it, of the negative narcissism, is that anything that ever happens to you is your fault. It's magically your fault. It's kind of like that nonsense with what do they call it? The book, The Secret. It's like you've manifested it, right? So like if something horrible happens to you, it's because you manifested it. If you get cancer, or if you lose your job, or if your kid gets sick, or well, no, the kid, if the kid gets sick, it's because they manifested it, but also you manifest. It's just, I mean, there's all these bullshit, nonsense, fucking little platitudes, which basically are geared to take away other people's moral agency. And it's like the vast majority of people in my life have never wanted to look at their own behavior. They've wanted the power, but they've never wanted the responsibility. So if something goes wrong in their life, it's me, it's not them, it's never them, never anybody else. It's always somebody else, it's never them. And likewise, I get people wanting to, like for example, Tim conned me. And yeah, I do share some responsibility in that. I admit that freely. However, I also am going to point out Tim's part in that. And I think that's the ethical thing to do. I'm not into this magical thinking where I have magical powers to make people do things that they don't want to do. If I could do that, I sure as hell wouldn't be in this situation. And I'm so sick of people just putting their negativity on me. It's just done with it. I've got so many people. Well, and it's not even so many, it's a handful. It just bugs. boggles my mind why I can make videos for 10 years and never get anywhere near 1,000 subscribers, much less 10,000. And yet other people go on YouTube and within a matter of months they've got 20,000-30,000 subscribers. They're, you know, rubbing elbows and bumping shoulders with, you know, other YouTubers just as successful as they are, and they're all a little clique or a little group, and they're sharing ideas and they're discussing things. And it really fucking gets to me, because it's like, I know damn well I'm on their level. And yet I get a little shit sitting there trying to claim that I never graduated college. That I don't read the books that I own. Oh my god. I mean, you know, it's just sickening. It's absolutely fucking sickening. And yeah, I am getting a nose job. As soon as after I get a car, saving up for the nose job, I'm getting rid of this fucking thing. This is just, it's frustrating because I feel like I got way too many people in my life who don't want me to be who I really am. And they're trying to convince me that who I really am is some horrible monster. It's just, I mean, it's like I'm a fucking nobody. So why do I have people fighting me so hard? Just doesn't make it. And if it's so funny and so lousy, why don't I have, you know, as many subscribers as Von Helton or Copper Cab or somebody? It's just, again, it doesn't make any logical sense. You know, because I look at it from reason, logic, and evidence, and I can't explain it. I mean, I'm literally, you know, I don't know, maybe it's magic, you know, maybe, I mean, that's what I have to sit there and think. So, yeah, that's reality.